Hey Leute, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Spirit of Justice. Im letzten Part haben wir herausgefunden, beim Revue-Passieren des Falls, dass ein Medium die wahre Macht der Kugel der Gründerin nutzen könnte. Denn in der Kugel der Gründerin war ja das Gesicht der Gründerin abgebildet, eine Statue von ihr, und damit könnte dann ein Medium die Gründerin höchstpersönlich beschwören und sich damit ihre Macht aneignen. Sehr interessant. Was das jetzt genau zu bedeuten hat, bin ich mir noch nicht ganz sicher. Ich habe schon ein paar Vermutungen beim letzten Mal erwähnt, aber wir schauen mal, was Apollo jetzt noch zu erzählen hat. Exactly. Through a spirit medium, the founder can quite literally return. And if the legend is true, the founder just might bestow spiritual power on someone when she does. It's like when Pearls imbued my Magatama with spiritual power. If a human could be imbued oder so with such power in a similar manner, it is said the founder possesses immense spiritual power. Such a great feat would not necessarily be beyond her. Wait a second, then the legend is true? Do you understand now, Mr. Attition Wimperson? You are holding hostage the final key to unlocking the orb's secrets. And if anything were to happen to her, the riddle would remain unsolved forever. Nah! Aber Maya ist ja nicht das einzige Medium, was das machen könnte. There's always Pearl Faye. I could simply ask her to help. If she wants money, I have plenty to offer. She's not the kind of person to be tempted by material gain. And she certainly wouldn't help you if anything were to happen to her cousin. Das stimmt. Aber es ist immer noch so komisch, dass Maya ihm überhaupt helfen wollte. Von Anfang an, das ist doch so ein Oberarsch. Was soll, hat sie das wirklich nur aus Macht gemacht, weil sie da diese spirituelle Kraft haben wollte? Und Phoenix hat dann auch noch geholfen. Hätte er nicht auch irgendwas anderes machen können? Er kennt doch die Situation sogar schon, dass Maya entführt wurde. Hm. Or maybe you'd like to go ask the Queen of Kirin to channel the founder for you, ja? He could, but he'd probably get executed for requesting such a thing. It's over. Now confess, you killed Dr. Buff, didn't you? It wasn't supposed to end this way. Mr. Attition Wimperson, are you admitting to committing the crime? You're my lawyer, right? Do something! It's true that I'm your lawyer, and as such, it's my job to defend you. However, defending my client isn't the only duty as a lawyer has. There's something else that's equally as important. And that is finding the truth. What? Mr. Attition Wimperson, you have sought to twist the truth in the dirtiest of ways. I was complicit in your hostage taking, but in a way, I was being held hostage too. Even so, there's still hope for me to make things right. And I owe it all to you, Apollo. Mr. Wright. I can't allow a murderer to walk away scot-free. Therefore, Mr. Attition Wimperson, I must resign as your attorney.
No, 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 no!
Does this mean I'm under arrest?
No!
Breakdown? Da bin ich jetzt sehr gespannt, was der Typ für einen Breakdown hat. Was? I've nothing to confess. What? I said I've nothing to confess. I don't and I won't, especially not to a plebeian like you. This guy doesn't know when to give up. Besides, there's no truth to these allegations. I mean, look at the suitcase. You won't find a single print of mine on it. All that means is you wipe them off, taking care to only leave Mr. Rebels. As many a great politician has said before me, no comment. In that case, try switching things up, Apollo. Look at the situation from a different angle. Is there really nothing that points to the suitcase being dropped from up above? Evidence that points to the suitcase being dropped from the second floor. Ja? Ich weiß jetzt, genau, weil Ami war ja auch da oben im Rollstuhl, als sie dann ohnmächtig wurde. Und sie wurde plötzlich weggeschoben. Sie wurde deswegen weggeschoben von der Tischen, weil sie im Weg war. Weil genau da der Koffer hätte runtergemisst, wo sie im Rollstuhl saß. Deswegen musste sie weg, damit er den Koffer dahin packen kann und den von oben runterfallen lassen kann. If the killer pushed the suitcase from the second floor hallway over the coffee bar, that would place him right around here. Ah, maybe, just maybe. Thought of something, Apollo. I believe this piece of evidence to be connected to the dropping of the suitcase. Soweit sehr vage. Ich glaube, dass dieser Beweis hier in Verbindung steht mit dem Herunterschmeißen des Koffers. Ja, die Aussage von Ami, dass sie weggeschoben wurde. Take that!
That appears to be a statement, but how is that related to this case?
On the night of the murder, Your Honor, Miss Ami Buff physically left her room. That's when she saw the doctor burning the orb and subsequently passed out. Right above the coffee bar. Mm-hmm. But with her there in her wheelchair, the killer wouldn't have been able to drop the suitcase down onto the doctor. Good point. However, according to Sarge, she woke up just as someone was trying to move her in her wheelchair.
Ah.
Mm-hmm. Someone was pushing my wheelchair. What? I was so scared. I beat a hasty retreat as fast as my wheels could take me. She must have been in the killer's way and had to be moved. Isn't that right, Mr. Attition Wimperson? And if the killer had pushed the wheelchair with his bare hands, he may yet find the conclusive evidence we need. Exactly. Fortunately for us, that evidence slipped right through the killer's fingers. If only he'd been able to hold on it just a little tighter. But now, he is neither able to discard nor alter it. Honestly, that piece of evidence wasn't even supposed to be here in this courtroom today. And yet, it looks like sometimes things do get better.
But this wasn't supposed to happen!
No. Well, too bad, because the evidence that sped away from you that night has come back to haunt you, right here at this very trial. Your Honor, the defense's final piece of evidence is on this person. Euer Ehren, der finale Beweis der Verteidigung ist an dieser Person dran, quasi. Der Rollstuhl von Ami. Take that, da sind seine Fingerabdrücke drauf.
That's...
On the night of the murder, Sarge passed out, only to come to and find that someone was pushing her wheelchair. That's when she fled back into her room. She didn't physically see a single soul after that. Not until Athena drew her out through the therapy session, that is. While the killer was able to wipe the prints on the suitcase, the same can't be said for the prints that got away.
My fellow Kryonians oder so.
Well, Mr. Politician Wimperson, try to explain your way out of this one. The podium is all yours. So, jetzt Breakdown. Los geht's.
Ah. Politician, savior of Kryon. I am not a crook. My political career.
It can't end like this. I'm destined for great things. Something's wrong. This isn't real. It's a dream. No, a nightmare. Ah! Huh? Election results. Wait, really?
Ah! Erster Sieger!
Ich?
Oh, no way! Banzai! Banzai!
Banzai! Politician arrested on murder charges and stripped of his electoral win. Ja, er wurde festgenommen. Und deswegen wird ihm sein Sieg abgestritten.
No, no, please! Wow! Grandpa!
Interessant.
Mr. Tyrion Wimperson, are you alright?
Der Blick vom Richter nach dem Breakdown ist immer das Beste.
Bailiff, get him to the first aid station on the double.
Okay.
Well, this was yet another unexpected turn of events. In light of everything that's been revealed, it seems the relic is indeed the Founder's Orb.
Ja, nee, das war schon seit Ewigkeiten klar.
And it seems Mr. Politician Wimperson can be considered a suspect in Dr. Buff's murder.
Apollo, I want to thank you for everything. Thanks to you, I didn't have to keep bending the truth. I don't know what I would have done without you.
Don't mention it. You were amazing today, Apollo.
Well, I couldn't have done it without Dirk.
A dragon never yields.
A dragon never yields.
Even when wounded, a dragon bites down hard and never lets go till its dying breath. It glares, it roars, and it latches its jaws firmly onto its prey till the bitter end. That's what lawyers do to get to the truth. A dragon never yields. Every lawyer should take that to heart.
As it seems, both sides have no further objections. Would Dirk Satmari please take the stand?
Kommt jetzt überhaupt not guilty oder kommt jetzt was anderes? Ist ja kein richtiger Strafprozess gewesen.
This court awards the orb to the Defiant Dragons per the stated transfer agreement. Ja, es steht nicht not guilty dran. Oh mein Gott. Aber Konfetti gibt's trotzdem. Yay.
Ja, es war echt eine coole Verhandlung. Hat mir gefallen. Ich hab's... Das Einzige, was ich komisch fand, ist, wie sich Phoenix und auch Maya verhalten hat. Ist es jetzt so, dass er Maya festgenommen hat? Oder halt festgehalten hat, ja. Aber auch, dass Maya die Wohltäterin ist, die dann ein gutes Wort für ihn einlegen wollte, wenn sie die Kugel der Gründerin dafür kriegt? Habe ich das richtig verstanden? War das... Das wurde jetzt nicht so genau gesagt, irgendwie, finde ich. Und das würde nicht zu Mayas Verhalten passen, finde ich. Und so Phoenix' Verhalten hat es auch nur so halb gepasst. Weil er war ja schon mal in dieser Situation. Er hätte eigentlich besser wissen müssen, was da zu tun ist. Anstatt da den Oberarsch frei rumlaufen zu lassen. Und den auch noch an die Macht kommen zu lassen. Den Mörder und Arsch-Politician. Also, da haben sich Phoenix und Maya, wenn es denn Maya war, ein bisschen komisch verhalten. Aber sonst war der Fall richtig cool, schon mal. Und ist noch nicht vorbei, der Fall. Es geht ja um die Revolution eigentlich. Die Revolution kam noch gar nicht. Die wird jetzt, das war erst die Einleitung quasi von dem Fall, glaube ich.
Should the Kingdom of Corain claim ownership, the matter may have to be deliberated in court all over again. I just hope, or shall I say pray, that I'm not the judge presiding over that one.
Presiding? Egal.
Indeed, a trial like that might spark an international incident. Still, there are bigger and more momentous things astir in the air.
The revolution. Dirk's really serious about this.
This court is adjourned.
Bam. Okay. Puh. Ja, ein bisschen ärgert's mich jetzt, dass ich da Game Over gegangen bin. ja, nur ein einziges Mal. Also einen Fehler habe ich halt zu viel gemacht. Und ich hätte es mir halt nur ein bisschen genauer anschauen müssen. Ich habe ja danach dann direkt gewusst, was es ist. Naja. Wie gesagt, es war eh ein Wunder, weil ich habe davor schon so viel Glück gehabt. Also ich habe es jetzt mal verdient, eigentlich fast schon, da jetzt mal, dass ich doch ein bisschen mehr Pech habe, dass mein Glück ausgeht. Aber ja, trotzdem sehr, sehr cooler Fall bisher und coole Verhandlung. Auch was ganz anderes eben, ein Zivilprozess zwischen Apollo und Phoenix, echt richtig cool gemacht. Nice work, Sam. We finally broken through the last obstacle on the road to revolution. Revolution just doesn't seem real. Yes, well, to think you actually defeated the fighting Phoenix. All I can say is, that's my boy. Well, Mr. Wright did have his hands tied. Who knows if I'd have won if he'd been able to fight me head on.
I see it more like you saved Mr. Wright.
Saved him?
Yeah, remember what he said? He didn't have to bend the truth anymore, and it was all thanks to you.
I don't know about that. Still, I guess it is kinda nice to be appreciated.
Mr. Dirk, now that the Holy Mother's face has been revealed, are you going to have a spirit medium try channeling her? I, for one, would love to see the return of the legendary founder.
Yeah, just think about it. Being able to speak to someone right out of the history books. Unfortunately, it's not that easy.
What? Why? A face isn't enough. You also need the true name of the one you're attempting to channel. Ja, da wüsste ich aber eine Person, die den kennt. Oh, right. Pearl mentioned something like that. And the founder's true name is only known to the priestess who's been crowned queen. Ja, und Maya auch. In short, the only living person who knows it is the current queen of Corrine, Garen. Nee, Maya weiß es auch. Oh, so without her help, we won't be seeing the founder anytime soon.
So, that's no fun.
Jetzt nochmal geupdatet, okay. The founder's form has appeared from... Das wurde schon 50 mal geupdatet übrigens. It seems only the queen knows the founder's real name. Es scheint wohl so, dass nur die Königin den wahren Namen der Gründerin kennt und man braucht ja Name und Gesicht. Ich bin doch nicht, oder? Maya kennt den doch auch. Weil als sie im dritten Fall da die Priesterin nachgespielt hat quasi, da hat sie doch diese Schriftrolle bekommen, wo da alle Infos dazu stehen. Und da stand doch auch der wahre Name. Ich weiß ihn gerade nicht mehr auswendig. Aber da stand doch der wahre Name von der Gründerin, oder? Wenn ich jetzt nicht spinne. Ich bin ziemlich sicher eigentlich. Also Maya kennt den. Und wenn sie die Schriftrolle noch hat, oder ich meine, sie weiß es ja, also sie könnte es ja jedem anderen einfach sagen. So. Also Maya würde auch gehen. So Dirk, what will you do now? First, I start by tracing the route by which the orb came into Dr. Buff's hands. Since we now know it was Politician that asked the doctor to study it, isn't he the one who stole it? No, a political nobody like him couldn't get anywhere near the orb, let alone steal it. He must have had inside help. My money is on someone connected to the royal family. Oh right, you said something to that effect back in the cave. Whoever it may be, we need to expose their dirty scheme to the light of day. Ja, ich sag Inga. Well, I'm sure Mr. Wright has plenty of information courtesy of his dirty client. He might be able to shed some light on this.
Private Justice! That was fine work you did at the trial today. You did your sergeant proud!
Back at you, Sarge. It took real courage to leave your room like that.
It's all thanks to you and Corpswoman Sykes. With my siege defense over, I can finally sally forth.
But the battle is only just begun! One for me and me alone to fight!
To lose your mother and then your father. What a terrible thing to endure.
Yeah, and being wheelchair bound it doesn't help.
Private Justice, I've been thinking. It's about time I stood on my own feet. After all, I no longer have Papa to coddle me.
Huh? I'm afraid I don't follow.
Take a good look, soldier. This is one small step for man. And one giant leap for me. Hold my drone for me, would you, Private Justice?
Yes, sir. What is she up to?
Los!
She's standing! What's this? Sarge, you mean your legs? There.
The doctor told me I was ready to walk again months ago. But if I admitted I could walk, I knew I'd have to leave the house. So I faked it.
Oh, makes sense, but...
I kept pretending I couldn't walk. But I know Papa is watching over me now, and I'd hate to disappoint him. So, from this day forth, I'm going to march forward on my own 2 feet.
What a brave kid, trying to move forward like this. But it must be so hard this soon after her father's death. Don't you ever stop. Just keep on walking, comrades. Stay brave, because there will be days when you'll want to stop. But I have faith you'll find a way to muster the strength to push through them. Yeah, you can do it.
Hey, Daddy's back!
Ich will eigentlich noch das zu Ende machen, auch wenn der Part dann jetzt ein bisschen länger wird. Mr. Wright, what's that look on his face for? Oh, Apollo. Is everything all right with Miss Faye? She's safe, for now.
Well then, we'd better go save her, quick! Where is she, anyway?
I'm afraid I have some bad news. Oh, nee.
Huh?
Maya's not here in the States. In Corrine! She's still in Corrine.
and she's still being held hostage by the mastermind behind this whole thing. The mastermind? That's right. Politician Wimperson was nothing more than a pawn. Maya's true abductor is in the kingdom of Kurain. Inga!
What?
I don't understand, Mr. Wright. What in the world's going on over there? But as shocking as that news was, it was only the beginning. The beginning of something big. Big enough to shake Kurain to its very core. Revolution. I was being swept up in a mighty wave that nothing could stop. Of course, at the time, I had no idea what the days ahead had in store for us. Okay, und es geht direkt hier weiter. Aber jetzt würde ich wirklich sagen, war es hier für diesen Part von Let's Play Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Spirit of Justice. Beim nächsten Mal geht es dann eben hier noch weiter. Wie gesagt, den ersten Teil hier vom fünften Fall haben wir jetzt. Diese gesamte erste Verhandlung da mit Politician, aber es ging halt vor allem darum, die Kugel der Gründerin zu erhalten. Die haben wir jetzt. Aber Maya ist noch immer in Gefahr, weil da noch irgendjemand Größeres dahinter steckt. Das wahre Mastermind hinter allem, nicht Politician. Das war mir auch klar, dass der kein Mastermind ist. Wie gesagt, ich vermute, Inga steckt hinter allem. Aber es könnte auch die Königin selber sein. Aber ich glaube eher, vielleicht auch sie beide gemeinsam, weiß ich nicht. Aber Inga steckt da auf jeden Fall irgendwie mit drin, würde ich mal vermuten. Und Apollo hat ja gerade schon so ein bisschen vorausschauend gesagt, dass noch sehr schlimme Dinge passieren werden. Ich bin gespannt, was er damit alles meint. Ich will es vielleicht gar nicht wissen, aber doch, ich will. Ich bin mega gespannt, wie es ja weitergehen wird. Wird weiterhin sehr cool werden. Okay, also dann Leute, bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao.